So welcome back to this third video where we are going to analyze the third important concept of this class. And it's an interest rate that we use every day and it's used worldwide. This rate is called LIBOR. I don't know if you have heard about it, but let me give you a very quick background about this concept of LIBOR. So I told you earlier that in this example, this guy is going to charge this other guy 0.5%. And I told you that was an interest rate. So this interest rate is the cheapest interest rate that you will find in the world. And why is that? Well, the main reason is because this guy is super rich and this guy is also super rich. So they will have to pay back each other. They have the money to pay them back. And the second reason is because they are banks and banks, they need to pay back their debts. If they don't pay their debts, they wouldn't exist, right? So they need to pay back. So if they are, if this guy is charging him 0.5%, it's because the risk of not being repaid is extremely low. So he's super rich, he needs to pay back because he needs to continue his business, he needs to maintain a reputation. So that's why the risk of repayment is very low. If we analyze a situation like this with maybe, I don't know, even myself, like a professor, right? The risk of paying back 10 million pounds is super high, right? Like, I don't know where will I get 10 million pounds in 1 year or something like that. So the risk, that rate should be higher. But in this case, this is the lowest rate that you will find in the world because the risk is extremely low. So we call this rate the interbank rate. It's because it's between banks. So it is always a reference. So I mind that you ask your British friend to lend you 10 million pounds. And if you are asking him for a 0.5%, it doesn't make any sense because the reference rate is this. This is the cheapest rate. So he will have to increase that rate. It's something similar to what we have in Mexico with TIIE. I don't know if you heard about it, because TIIE is a reference rate. We use TIIE, is the cheapest rate. That is a rate from the government. If you give money to the government, they will pay you that, the TIIE, the Tasa Interbancaria de Equilibrio. It's a little bit similar in terms of the reference, but it's different in terms of how it is calculated. So now let me tell you that. Let me tell you how do we calculate LIBOR. So LIBOR, surprisingly, it's super easy to calculate the LIBOR because the LIBOR is the average at which banks lend money between each other. So maybe this guy charge him 0.5%, but maybe another bank will charge 0.7%. So in average, it's 0.6. So the LIBOR will be 0.6. That's kind of how do you calculate the LIBOR. It's extremely easy. It's only a matter of calculating the average. So something that you need to take note about LIBOR is that it is the cheapest rate because the risk of not paying back is extremely low. It's the most popular reference rate in the world because everyone thinks about and uses LIBOR to calculate other rates or to calculate the price of derivatives or to calculate things that we're going to learn in the second and third partial. And it also helps people to calculate the interest rates of their own loans, like a private loan or whatever. But it has a risk of failure. And I will talk about this in the next video.